Hello, everybody. Welcome to Caldera. This is your very first look at the brand new Warzone experience coming in just under a day now at this point. I'd like to give a huge thank you to the Call of Duty team and all of the wonderful developers that made this early play session possible with myself amongst many of my peers. There were hundreds and hundreds of us that had the opportunity to jump in and play. But I just want to let you know before we really get into things here, I'm not that good at Warzone. I think a lot of you guys know that. I'm not that good at Warzone, but I tried my best here. I was going up against some of the best Warzone players in the world, some of the best streamers and content creators. And even though I wasn't able to secure a victory, I wasn't expecting to secure one, I still had a great time sightseeing. I should mention that everything you're seeing here today was recorded on my PC. I did not play on console, therefore I cannot confirm nor deny if there's going to be an FOV slider on console. They still haven't said anything. They didn't tell us anything about it during our play session, unfortunately. But at least on the PC, I can say that this map looks absolutely gorgeous, man. This is one of those experiences that I find myself wanting to come back to, not necessarily to win the match, but just to explore every little nook and cranny that exists here on Caldera. I want to get a private match together and just completely sweep the entire area. Explore the volcano, and I want to explore the lagoon and the armory. I want to be able to learn how to use a plane a little bit better. And planes weren't that hard to fly, by the way. They were actually pretty intuitive and very easy to use. I will say this, though. The plane fighting was fantastic in terms of not only being part of it, but watching it from the ground. I never had a good opportunity to get into a dogfight with another player, but I did witness a lot of it happening, and that was pretty damn cool. At one point, we were getting shot down out of the air, and I jumped from the plane trying to shoot towards any enemy that's still flying a plane, and there's bullets whizzing past you, and you're pulling your parachute to make sure you don't descend too quickly, and you're firing your weapon, you're trying to reload, you're trying to take the enemy out in the cockpit. The entire thing was a blast. It was something that I did not expect to experience in a Call of Duty title. There were a couple of things that happened during our gameplay that I'm guessing will most likely get fixed before the release, but I'm not entirely sure if it's intentional. Like, for example, right here when we dropped in and we started to loot, we noticed all these little money symbols around the map. Those didn't disappear when we landed. So the entire time our HUD was obstructed by these money symbols, and it really made it difficult to see if there were enemies coming directly in front of you or if something was happening in front of you because you had this big symbol up on the screen. I don't really know why that was happening, but like I said, this will probably not be there when the game launches. I could be mistaken though. I want to show you guys what the cinematic to the gulag looks like. The gulag itself takes place in the phosphate mines. So what happens is you get thrown underground and that's where your fight begins. There's like mining tracks all around and a little shanty town directly in the center. And you have the stands, or I guess you would say the narrow walkways up above, to watch what's happening down below. You can still throw rocks and stuff like you can in every other gulag. But this is a pretty interesting situation to say the least, because it's a brand new experience. It's not based off of a multiplayer map that exists. It's not like Standoff or Hijacked or anything of the sort like that. Instead, it's a new spot to go. And when you win your gulag, at least when I did here, I ended up respawning in a plane and I wasn't exactly prepared for that. So yeah, definitely fails all around on that end. If you want to see what the Warzone victory screen looks like, look no further than right here. This is J-God's team, Sparrows and Marksman, and I think Modern Warzone was on it. They won every single match, like every single one we ever played. They are currently undefeated in Caldera. So it's up to those of you online, if you happen to come across them in game, you need to take them off of their throne. They have not been defeated in this map yet. When dropping into the map, it's very similar to that cutscene that we saw earlier on where the plane starts to get taken out from the sky, the engine is failing, and that's when you drop down into the map itself. This is pretty cool. I like the drop-in sequence. I think that it definitely is unique, but we have the best plane in the world because for some reason, it doesn't actually fall any lower. It stays at the same altitude the entire time. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to let some raw footage play out. I'm going to let you guys listen to the sights and the sounds and our operators and take it all in. But before we do, I just simply want to say that as someone who didn't necessarily enjoy Verdansk to the fullest, and as someone who mainly played Blackout the entirety of the year, I think that this is a really good way to get me to play Warzone a lot more than I already was. This map interests me way more than Verdansk ever did, and I think that there's just so many things to look at, so many sites to find, and so many secrets to discover that I can't wait to get back in when it fully releases and just explore the entire map on my own. I'm hoping that I can jump into private matches if that's a thing, and if not, well, I guess I'm going to be jumping into Plunder and just doing that the entire time. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching my early coverage of Caldera. If you enjoyed, drop a like on this video, subscribe for more. I will have much more coverage of Season 1 coming over the next few days, and I really, really appreciate all of the support on my channel. So without further ado, enjoy the gameplay, and I will catch you all on the next one.
Yes, he's moving.
Hits are coming. I'm not dead yet.
Soldier incoming.
Big cow rounds would be good.
Catch you.
Enemy soldier.
survive this and you get to redeploy. The fight begins. Taunting is an effective way to mess with the enemy's head. So is a heavy rock. A fight has started. Right, next. Ready up. Win here and you return to the battlefield. Lose and your fight is over. It's time, soldier. We're going back to the front. Allied UAV overhead. Hunt them down. Enemy UAV active. Hostile dropping into the area. You got gas inbound. Safe zone relocated.
Take that armor.
He's moving. Objective updated. Defend that position. Recon intel secured. Job well done.
Getting ready.